Hello and welcome back. It's that time again. What is that time? It's that time to go ahead and do the thing. And the thing that we're going to do, of course, is play Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. Now, this is episode 3. Might be a little hard to tell, right, because I'm starting back from Majula, but I stopped at Majula because I wanted to do a little bit of leveling up, get some items, and we're going to go back, and we're going to travel to the Forest of the Fallen Giants, which is where we were, and we're going to go to the Cardinal Tower, which is where we left off. Now, I'm probably making a lot of fast progress for people, but I'm hoping that if someone's actually using this to kind of learn to play through the area, that, that you're actually getting something out of this, right? That you're seeing, oh, man, you know, look at all these cool items. Look at all the things I can do. You know, I don't have to be this soft, squishy thing. I can just kind of go wherever. And also, you know what? We're going to pick up an item. We're going to do some jolly cooperation. I'm hoping that the PlayStation 3's online is still alive. I'm going to assume so. We're going to go up to this door up here. This, what is it? It is a locked door. Well, geez, too bad it's made out of tattered wood. All right, so let's break a trope here. That's one thing I like about it. We're going to chop down that door. Great, there's some items in here, by the way. There's a lot of cool stuff in here. Also, there is a treasure chest that you can break. Do not attack wooden treasure chests. They will break. And you really want that small leather shield and that repair powder. Repair powder is good because, of course, you know, your items and all that, they can break. You know, look at me bouncing around like a fool, just destroying things. Ah, man, I'm so weak. Ugh! All right, now, also, in the last episode, I did go ahead and I upgraded my strength so I could actually equip that new shield. Now, I'm not going to equip my strength, or I'm not going to up my strength a lot because my character build doesn't really depend on strength to survive. In fact, what does she do? She's cunning ingenuity, and she is stuff, right? So, let's go ahead and let's get that shield now. That one there, or, let's see here, 50, 75, 75, 50, what are the differences in stats? Not a lot of stuff I care about right now at this point in the game, so I'm gonna go with the Crimson Varma. Okay. We got a couple shields already to play with, so I'm going to go ahead and open this door. Brr! There we go. And I need to be careful because there's always this guy. Yeah, and for the longest time, I couldn't figure out where is he coming from, right? He's just hanging out in the corner like he's a statue. He's not a statue. Oh, he gave me a bastard sword. That's nice. I could totally use that, and I could also totally use what's in the box. And what is in the box, my friends? What is in the box is our first multiplayer item and an Estus Flask shard, so that's cool. That's gonna hurt. Now, actually, there's an item that's on that tree branch that I do kind of want, so I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna kind of redo that because I forgot about it as I was going down. Now, I say that's terrible, right? You know, I'm trying to give you a useful let's play, and I'm gonna miss an item that like I want, and I guess I want to grab all the items that I can. It's always good to have as many resources as you can. And for me, also, it enables me to help out others as I play online, so. Yep. There we go. Pick up item. Divine Blessing. Very useful item, especially this early in the game. Now, I want to talk to her, and I actually want an item that she has. And I don't have a way to afford it yet, though. Because not only do you level up with souls, but you also spend souls like they're money. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to go this way. We're gonna go to the land where something sings. What is it? Palm Tree Sway, actually. Oh, okay, yeah. What is that? This is that song I liked it from National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. No! Nah. Did I tell you could do that? No. Come on, come on. Undead Don Quixote. Go away. Fight a windmill. Do the thing. All right, so he died a little. That's okay. We wanted him to die a little. What we also want to do is we want that item there. And jeez, it's a little precarious. Let's make the jump. We risked it a little bit. We did it. We got it. Human effigy. All right, these things are actually kind of rare. Now, I realize I'm picking them up like they're candy, but what do? They let us... Man, did you see that? Oh, I totally timed that wrong. All right, so I just lost 638 souls. It's all right. Souls are not really that hard to come across, though. I get confused as to why people talk about this game being hard. Okay, the only two times that I've died, and this is video 3, by the way, so I'm actually still at my ratio here. of deaths. That's 3-2. And, you know, maybe I should add a sound effect or something. Probably not. You know, like they're you know, there's stuff I could do post-processing that maybe I'll do when I get a chance to kind of make content at a more reasonable pace. Right now, I'm just trying to crank it out. But not just cranking it out, but cranking out quality content. I'm not ever recording when I'm not in the frame of mind to do it. And luckily, I've been in the frame of mind to do it a pretty reasonable amount. Look at all these bloodstains. Bloodstains are basically where other people died. And so as I die, I get to spread my bloodstain to other areas. And I knew he was coming. I'm just gonna, yeah. Sometimes the backstabs are a little bit harder to time. Well, not even timing. It's actually getting the right angle that's the difficult part. Different weapons have different areas at which they can actually affect. Now, oh, I gotta do the sort of risky jump again just to get my souls back. Which I totally failed, and that's okay. Oh, hey, how's it going, man? Gee whiz. Fancy meeting you here. Hey, fell a little. We got 50 souls out of that. All right, well, I mean, like, what? I only need to kill, like, 12 of them to get those souls back. So, All right, so that's going to be a little bit harder to get. And at this point, I might just, like, forget it. I don't care. I don't need those. Well, I do. I do because I want to talk to the lady. The lady has stuff I want, actually. And we, you know, what lady, right? Well, there was, like, a person that we could have talked to. So I'm gonna play it cool here and kind of keep my distance because there's a lot of opportunities to die down here with all these enemies, actually. I don't need to soul arrow everyone to death. Now, and in my opinion, you okay? He's just knocking his head out of there on the ground there. Okay. Love the physics. In the first Dark Souls, actually, you kill enemies and they get stuck on your feet and you, like, you know, you carry them around like ragdolls. I don't remember this one being like that. I think they actually changed the ragdoll physics for the enemies once they're dead. But now, that doesn't mean that other items aren't sort of influenced by this physics engine. All right, cool. So what have we done? We've gone about everywhere down here. Yeah, there's an item in the corner. It's a life gem. Okay, life gem times 3. That's very cool. And then there's that. You know, and I can't remember how to get that, actually. As funny as that is, I really don't. No, I got some statues here. Oh, let's make them crumble. All right, cool. So fire everywhere. Why not have a drink? We're going to go in here and, you know, of course, touch the bloodstain message. Right about here is probably where it's too dangerous to move forward. Okay, so what does that thing do? That thing shoots. And a no! Oh, in a pattern of 3, right? Okay. I forgot about these clowns. So we can totally do this. All is not lost. Ooh, we traded blows. That was terrible. I forgot about those guys, though. All right, so we got those little Komodo things here, and they shoot fire, and it's like, oh, man, are you serious? Yeah, you do actually happen to be pretty safe there. So we're going to go ahead, and we're going to open this up, and we're going to get a da-da-da-da. Well, you know, like, cue the Zelda music. Fire longsword. Now, let me look at the stats for that, though. I'm pretty sure that I can't come anywhere close to equipping it with my character the way it's built. Yeah, like 20 and 11, okay? But at some point, that should be, like, some target stats. And we're gonna go ahead, and we're going to pick up our souls, because I think we got everyone down here. I think we got all the items that are down here. And that's good, right? That's exciting. And I'm going to go ahead and grab my souls, because at that point, it'll top me off at over 1,000, and that's where I want to be. So we're going to shimmy, and shake up the ladder. Come on, shimmy and shake. There we go. Okay. All right, good.
It's the shake.
All right, cool. And we retrievaled our souls. And I could attempt to make that jump back, but then I'd hate it. I would hate it so much if I actually tried to make that jump and I, like, died doing the jump. So I'm just gonna kind of meander back through here. Like, yeah, you see how much damage that does? That's crazy. I don't want to lose these souls. I worked pretty hard to get those souls. And at this point, that's maybe, yeah, it's like a good, what, 10 minutes of farming? at a certain point, you have to learn how to cut your losses, and you never want to rush an area just because you want to get to your souls, because that's actually a way to really just lose more souls, and I don't want to lose more souls. Yeah, okay. Cool. What are we going to do? We're going to go in the window ledge. Do we remember this area? We totally should. Too slow. Probably should be careful, though. I can break my thing. All right, you know what? Yeah. Oh, I forgot I had a shield, too, now. I feel so cheap doing that. And then, of course, there's this guy here. Oh, I was so sure that it would actually clear that little gap there. Is it really just not? There we go. All right, magic missile time. Good stuff. Okay. We got that guy there. He's a little dead. Well, we're all a little dead, I suppose. I die each night just a little bit. All right, cool. Now I like to iteratively make progress. So I like to make some progress and then do some things and then come back and go to Majula and level up or do whatever silly thing I want to do. We're going to go ahead and rest at the bonfire. It's going to reset all the enemies. And you'll notice I'm still dead. I'm choosing to be dead at the moment. There's not really a big disadvantage. I'm going to help the old lady by buying something. We're going to go ahead and we're buying a key item here. Literally, a lemongrass key. And very cool. Now, she's also got some soul gems, but they're kind of expensive for us at this point in time, so it's not worth to get, unfortunately. Now, what we are going to do is we're going to go ahead and exhaust all of her We're going to go ahead and exhaust all of her dialogue. Her name is Malentia, and, you know, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. She travels, and it's high time that she picks up and moves. Whoops, I'm pressing the button too many times. Lowly times is all. Oh, gosh, that's awful. All right, so next time that we come here, she won't be there. Why? Because she has actually now moved to Majula. And so we're going to the Far Fire. Not the Fart Fire, but the Far Fire. And I don't know why I made that joke. That was terrible, right? That was a terrible joke. Why do you let me make these terrible jokes? I'm going to check the time here. Oh, it's after 10. Wait, oh, it's actually a good deal after 10. No, wait, I'm a liar. It's after 9. It's close to 10, and I basically built this little binary watch, and it's awesome, and sometimes I look at it, and I totally mistake what time I think it is. Okay, so we're going to go ahead, and we're going to open this. This is what Leningrass Key actually opened. Yep, and we're going to open that quick, and we're going to go to this treasure chest. We're going to get some cool items out of there, or a cool item out of there. And we'll talk to him, let him know that he's open for business.
Ah, yes. Very good. Now I can get to work. But first, let me set up. Come again later.
So basically all you need to do in that regard is to come back later, like much, much later. Well, not much later. Really, the moment that you leave, he's set up. So the moment that you come back, he's already good. Alright, so what are we going to do? Equipment, we are going to... Actually, I'm a liar. We're going to go ahead and we're going to eat some souls, because that sounds delicious, and I'm very hungry. So let's go ahead and use... Alright, you know, what does that give me? That gives me 200, but look at this guy. That's pretty big. Ah, 2 grand. Alright, got a little over 2,000 souls. And...
Here.
Yeah, we're going to update our Estus flag here. Upgrade it. We're going to go from SS Flask A to SS Flask 8.1. We're going to get our start menu back with that. We're going to level up. I like leveling up. In fact, we're going to... intplusone. Ha ha ha! See the meta reference. It's fun. Okay, cool. So, I like that. It increases our casting speed. And also, I'm also trying to build a specific type of character, actually. So, like, I'm a mage, hooray, you know, being a mage is fun. But being a really powerful mage is kind of what matters. So that's what we're gonna do. We're a little strong right now. For, like, this early on in the game, we're just gonna wheel and deal a ton of damage, and that's fine. So we're gonna go back to the Cardinal Tower. I might as well do this in kind of semi the right order, right? So, What is that co-op item that I got? Oh yeah, you know what? We're gonna do some online co-op. I did set it up to where I can hear them through the speakers if they happen to have the settings enabled to do the audio. If they haven't, we won't hear them. And if they don't have a headset, we won't hear them. Actually, there's a number of conditions that make it to where hardly anyone actually talks online on the PS3 version, especially given the fact that it's not enabled by default. Now, why are you still here? Yeah, it is high time. You'd pick up and leave. All right, well, these are lowly times then, because I think you're supposed to move. I don't know why you're still here. That's okay. What are we going to do? We're going to go down, down, down into the ground, feeling... Oh, yeah. What is that? That's Korn. That was from Issues, which that CD had Issues. But it was actually a pretty good album. I think that everyone kind of knocked it because it didn't sound like some of the more traditional sounding stuff. But, I don't think that's actually terrible. Are you dead? I can never remember. I feel like somebody comes back to life in this. Yeah, like him. You know what? Maybe I should unequip the binoculars? Ah, maybe I should get out of here for a second. No! Oh, man. So that was an accident. That's death 3 of 3, and this is video 3. So, man, I'm not on target, unfortunately, for my death ratios. Losing just a little bit here. Now, what happened is I wanted to go and press the shield button, forgot that I did not equip my shield. Oops. So instead of blocking, I actually stood there like a dummy and said, I'm a push button, or what is that, a push pin? But a push pin isn't, it's a pin cushion. I'm a pin cushion, right? I am a big giant pin cushion. There we go. Now I can do the thing. So we got 30 soul arrows. No souls, but that's okay. We're going to go down here, and we're going to check it out. And, of course, we remember the enemy placement. They're not permanently dead yet, etc., etc., etc. I'm going to save my soul arrows, because it's going to be a while before I get to go anywhere cool. I like that. And I could actually work on my stamina to even be a little bit more efficient here. All right, so we forgot about this guy. Or rather, we didn't technically know about him. Like, you as the audience might have known about it. Like, oh man, you need to pay attention. Yeah, I'm paying attention. I'm just not doing it well. That's okay. We're gonna drink some Estus. And we're gonna... Soul of Lost Undead. Soul Stained Back. Now, unfortunately, that's not a cool raggedy door that I see there. It is, in fact, a regular... raggedy looking door, so I can't just cut it down. Man, that'd be nice. Because I can go to try and open it. Oh, it's locked. And it's for real, it's locked. You see, it's reinforced with some metal. Okay. So that's cool. I don't know what I'm trying to do. Well, I know what I'm trying to do, but I shouldn't do it. So, okay. Alright, so we could homeward bone, but I don't want a homeward bone anywhere. Let's see here. Let's open this. Oh, no, you know what? We can't. Instead, what I have to do is I have to be a big jerk and I need to make a lot of noise. At least I think so. If this is the door I'm thinking it is. One of the doors, you basically can make enough noise to where they'll open it for you from the other side. And it might not be that door. I swear it is, though. Maybe I'm just not making enough noise. Ah, listen to me! No? Huh. Okay. Really could have sworn that that's the door that I'm thinking of. That's alright. I am known to be wrong frequently. It's one of the joys of being human, actually. I enjoy being wrong. It means that I get a chance to maybe get it right later. So, I'm really... I swear this door does open, in fact. Alright, so how far am I going to play today? I'm not sure. And I kind of am going to end up, like, uploading these videos over a period of time anyway. So, you know, regardless of where I get in this playthrough, you might not even see it today. So, I've got some ideas where to go, actually. What do I want to do? I want to go... No. There are things that I want to do specifically, actually. I want to first go ahead and get behind these things. I do know what I want, though. I want you to go away. And there's something specific I'm trying to trigger, actually. So one of the cool things about the Souls series is shortcuts. Right? Activating shortcuts. And there is a shortcut coming up. And it's so easy to find by accident under the right set of circumstances. But the right set of circumstances does not always happen. And so I'm going to go and... You see Mr. Firebomb here? I want him to throw the firebomb over here. There we go. Oh, wait, no. Did it work? I can't tell. I thought it did. No, it didn't. Okay. It's all right. That's what I wanted. All right, do you see that? That is what you call a shortcut. It makes my life easier. It makes our lives easier as we enjoy this together. I'm actually only at about the 20-minute mark, so I'm going to keep going. That sounds like a plan. I like my plan. So we're going to go back this way, though. I'm not worried about Mr. Firebomb here. I am going to kind of, woo, kind of meander here. Not really worried about them either. I mean, I should kill them, though, because what they'll do is they'll follow me and they'll make my life miserable. Or they'll make my life dead. I'll tell you, man, the healing animation in general on all the healing items is a pain in the butt. No! All right. What did I say I wasn't going to do? I said I wasn't going to die. So I'm going to do this. Yeah, I could have ended the video and then I wouldn't actually have that pressure. It's not really pressure, though, right? Like, I voluntarily chose to, like, set that as an arbitrary goal. So yeah, it's not arbitrary, you know. I do kind of want to do this. What do I want to say professionally? I don't know that that's the right term. Oh no, you didn't. Oh, that's so worth it. Those binoculars, man. They are. I don't want to say that they're cheap. They're really not cheap. Hey, look at that. Look who's being smart. Yes, rush to your death. Oh, heck. Oh, that hurt. I'm still locked on and having some trouble with the camera. Okay. There we go. Did not mean to do that and stuck. Dang it, stuck on the trees. Whoa, okay. Now, I did not mean to get into the fold, but I can save this. I do not have to die here. I do not have to consume all my life gems. Unfortunately, though, I am consuming more than I planned. I'm already down to 8 left. Like, that's no fun. I want to hold on to these so I can guarantee that I can heal later, because it's still a while before I can actually guarantee that I can buy them, and it's a while before I can really guarantee that I can afford them easily. And I don't farm. You know, it's something that I try to avoid. I mean, unless I'm specifically trying to meet a goal, like, and it's part of the game. But this game doesn't, it doesn't technically really require farming. Although, you know, one could actually make the argument that it does. It depends on what your goals are in this game. Yeah, I'm aware I just took damage. Alright, so he's just gonna fall over like a little ragdoll that he is. And... Yeah, no, Gina, you're not gonna get me, okay? Okay. Apka karta hahihe. What in the world do you think you're doing, right? Do you think you're going to kill me? Because you aren't going to get me. I am the gingerbread man. Woman. Well, I am Kalane, right? Where am I from? Maybe I'm from Astora. I'm from the same place that our buddy Solaire is from. If you play Dark Souls 2, or what? If you play Dark Souls 1, you know, of course we have Solaire of Astora. He teaches us, of course, about the joys of jolly cooperation. He's a great character. He's just an exceptionally cheery guy. Depending on how you play things, his life is either great or tragic. Oh, you know what I just did? I just did something so irritating. I actually backtracked by accident. I can't go back up that wall. So what do I have to do? I have to go around, and that's okay. I can do that. In the meantime, I gotta go through the river and over the woods to grandmother's house we go. Don't ask me how. We're gonna snorkel, I guess. And, you know, man, I hope I don't accidentally keep using, like, the same jokes. Hopefully you don't watch all my videos. Actually, no, hopefully you do, right? Hopefully you enjoy them. Hopefully you enjoy the B-sides, actually, right? That's one of the cool things. InPlusOne channel and me, really, by extension, because, Indiana Jones time here. InPlusOne channel is all about cooperation, collaboration, forging alliances, and hopefully soon, raising money for some awesome causes. And I keep saying it, but I will talk about that as soon as I can make the arrangements to make that happen. And what do I have to do first? Well, I need to at least hit my initial cost of investment here. Because I'll tell you, getting this off the ground was rough, especially, it doesn't matter. Let's just say that I appreciate any support that my viewers can give, right? Totally check me out. I really like subscriptions. Subscribe me.
I'm sorry.
So this guy, his name is Kale. He's a cartographer. Navigate. He likes maps. He talked to him a couple times. He doesn't actually necessarily know why he likes it.
It was a curse? Something about a curse.
And see, the thing about the curse of the undead is that, you slowly go hollow. And what happens when you slowly go hollow? Well, you become a little less human, but you also lose the ability to kind of form memories usefully.
Dranglik, the lost kingdom.
And so that poor guy, he's kind of on the verge of, he's kind of on the verge...
I believe, now, yes.
...of becoming a hollow himself.
Then what?
And he doesn't necessarily matter.
That wonderful shame on you. Here, take this.
All right, cool. Now, so there's a big house in Majula, and it's actually the mansion. That's where he was talking about that he squatted at. And that enables us to do some really cool stuff. Okay, now I might be skipping an item, but I don't think I'm skipping anything important. Because what I want to do is I want to get back to the tower, the Cardinal Tower. Now, I don't think there's anything this way at all. I think it's just where it fell through. Yeah, I mean, that's actually a ledge. Oh, and you'll notice these orange signs everywhere. If you've never played Dark Souls 2, these orange signs basically are messages left typically by other players. And it's sort of like this really cool communal way to play games. And so what do I mean by that, though? Well, say I know something's ahead. I can use this fancy little thing. It's like a menu that allows me to... create a message. Now, I have yet to get the message creating item, do you start it? Yeah, you might start it this game with it. I know in the original Dark Souls, I think you have to get it. I think it's like the orange sign, soapstone, or something like that. Everything's a soapstone. Oh, we want to go down here, though. There is something down here. Okay. Good. Oh, good. Ah, Dios mio. All right, come on. There we go. Hey, torch. I forgot about torches. Originally, when they first announced this game, they actually had this really amazing graphics engine component that they're working on. Some, like, really awesome dynamic lighting tools that it turned out did run on the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360, but did not run efficiently. What does that mean? That means that a lot of slowdown, a lot of stuttering. Okay, so they would run it, and they would find, man, this is not really usefully playable, even though we totally showed this set of graphics to people when we were trying to sell the game. So what did they do? Well, they eventually did release a PC version, but it was still on par with this. And then, of course, you know, you had awesome utilities, kind of like the DS fix on the original Dark Souls. No! Okay, yeah, there we go. And then, also, too, what they did, they released this on the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. And I'll be honest, I really want to have those versions, but I've got to get my financial house in order. And I don't know why she's not moving. She always is supposed to move. Now, It's strange to me that she hasn't moved yet, unless, you know, I've done something. I've circumvented some little trigger she needed to leave. What do we want to do? We want to pick up more soul arrows, actually. So I know I was going to level up, but instead we have those two attunement slots. And that was part of how I wanted to build my character. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to do. Wait, how do you do that? Oh, shoot. Oh, that's right. You can only attune at bonfires. All right, now, what does that do? That gives me 60 casts of Soul Arrow. I live, breathe, and die on Soul Arrow at the beginning of this game because of the way that I'm building my character. Now, I'm going to go back to Majula. I'll probably end every video at a bonfire, and I'll probably end every video at Majula, unless there's just no compelling reason for me to visit there, because I feel like there's always something that I want to do and that I can do. Like, for instance, we're going to visit the mansion, and I'm really hoping that the old lady shows up there. I'm like almost disappointed that she's not there. I feel like it's supposed to happen, actually. Maybe if I leave the game and come back, it'll work out okay. But yeah, that wall right there, that's where she usually sits. All right, Crimson Herald.
Bearer.
Seek, lest. Okay, so I don't think I have anything to level up my Estus Flask with. Oh, you know what? I can't do that yet. You want to know why? Because I didn't consume myself. Man, he looks pretty cool. Those must be some of the DLC items that I've never seen. What is that even that he's holding? It's like some kind of crazy spear. Okay. Now I want to press buttons. And the button... Oh, no. The button I want to press is the start button. Man, I'm getting a little tired bit. So I might actually stop after the next video and jump back into Enchanted Arms. And then I'd like to actually finish up some 3D Dot Game Heroes, but... You know, it's only realistic to do but so much. But I'm lucky, all right? I hadn't been able to provision a lot of time outside of the things that I've been doing. A lot of school work. I'm actually going to two different schools right now. It's been a heck of a thing to manage. Oh, you know what? Those are just souls of lost undead. They're not even enough for us to level up on. So let me look at the time. All right, we're at the 32-minute mark. That's great. So I'm going to head to the mansion. So there's some really cool stuff in the mansion. We want to go ahead and grab that. We want to make sure that, we want to make sure of stuff. Stuff everywhere. We've only joined, like, one covenant. Usually by this point in time, I think I've joined several. But in an effort to make this, you know, like, commentary, you know, I'm not, oh yeah, Pharaoh's Lockstone. That's a cool item, that's worth talking about at some point. Maybe not now. But they basically are used to unlock things, right? It's a lock stone. You might be like, well, duh. It's really obvious. Why you gotta say obvious things? Well, you know what? Fine. I'm not gonna tell you about this skeleton that's about to attack me in a moment. Oh, that's not a treasure chest. That's right. I always look at it and think, man, is that a treasure chest? Now, there's some interesting stuff going down here. And so this is Dark Souls 2, okay? But really, there's not a lot of common thread that seems to intertwine them. So that skeleton, he's actually a bit of a powerful enemy. And he can parry, which is terrible. But so in the original Dark Souls, there was an item called the Lord Vessel. And this right here, it's subtle, right? This is what I talk about when the game gives you storyline in a very subtle way. This is the Lord Vessel right here. It's all broken. What broke the Lord Vessel? What's a Lord Vessel? Well, we'll get into that some other time. Or, you know what? No, even better. Don't listen to me about it. Listen to Vati Vidya. He is an amazing kind of Let's Play kind of guy. And what he does is he talks a lot about the Soul series. And he's very passionate. And he's got this really great kind of, you know, intonation tone when he talks about it. You know, he's like a storyteller. That's what he is. He's a storyteller. He's a lore interpreter. And I'll tell you what, he has managed to piece together some things that are impressive. Now, can I say that they're canonical? No. What I can say, though, is that they are insightful. Okay. I'm actually trying to get upstairs, and I cannot recall how one does such a thing. Ah, this way. There's no more enemies to worry about in here. That one lowly skeleton, and then those things that you hear in the background, they're pigs. And, you know, you're like, oh, man, these, you know, cute little piggies, right? They're pretty great. No, they're pretty, like, greatly terrible. They'll just totally destroy your behind. Like, they don't give a care. I don't give a care. Alright, now, I think that's everything in that room. I got all these, alright, so I've jumped from subject to subject. So the torch is basically, they had a lighting rendering engine, and then they had to change it. So there were areas in the game that you were supposed to actually kind of like have to use a torch to do. And there's really only like maybe one, two possibly areas that I consider a torch to maybe be your best friend. But it was supposed to be a lot more. There was supposed to be a lot more of that, and it was kind of strategically necessary to use those. But what do I want to do? I want to go ahead and I want to sit at the bonfire. I want to rest my legs, rest my tuchus. And I think I'm going to end here, right? So we're going to sit by the campfire. We're going to sing Kumbaya. Kumbaya, burning sword. And what I want to do, I want to hear from you. I want you to comment. I want you to tell me if you're enjoying, right? Like, I hope that this game is still relevant enough to where people actually care about it. I kind of hope so. And I know that when Dark Souls 3 comes out, which I'm excited for, and I think that's slated for March of 2016, so, like, that's not even that far away. This is almost October. What? This is almost October. And so what does that mean? That means that we might actually get to play that soon. Now, it'll probably be a little delayed. I don't know, though. I mean, it's Namco Bando. Wow. It's Namco Bandai. And it's from Software. And so I don't necessarily think it's going to be like a Half-Life 3 kind of deal, because they're pretty consistent about the release schedule. But I don't know that I'll count on it coming out in March of 2016. So we'll see. Anyway, I want to thank you for joining me. I hope it's been entertaining. And thanks for watching intplusone channel. Please subscribe. Please face us on Likebook. And please like the video if you liked it. If you hated it, absolutely press the down. And, you know, do the Roman thing and send me into lions. I don't need to be doing this if you hate it, right? I want to get feedback from you, though. I want to make this better. I want to keep bringing the energy. And you know what? I'll see you later. Hasta luego.